Engon comes with its own powerful asset browser. You can open it from the Engon panel inside the Polygonic tab. You can open the asset browser in a new window or click the Browse Assets button and choose the area where you want to open the browser. Inside, you will be presented with a list of all the assets that are registered into Engon. If you do not see any, watch the Asset Packs installation video to learn how to install Asset Packs in the Engon. The link will be provided in the description. You can spawn the asset by clicking its asset name under the asset preview. If you need additional information about the asset, you can click the magnifying glass icon that will open the asset detail. You can see additional parameters about the asset. Those parameters are used also for the filtering. As for the browser itself, it consists of several parts. In the top left corner, you can find the category navigation. To enter a category, click the category name. Note that all search and filtering will happen inside the active category that you are in. To go back to the parent category, just click its name. Next, there are tags and filters. You can use those to further refine your search. For example, we can search for materials that have displacement and are of a certain color. To reset the filters, you can reset the individual filters by using the X button next to the filter, or you can reset all filters at once by using the X button at the top. Another example of a query would be to search certain botanic assets that are in certain dimensions. Let's say we want to search all assets that are higher than 5 meters and less than 10 meters. Now you are presented with a filtered view where you will see only the assets matching your criteria. Another type of filtering is the asset data type filter. You can search only for particle systems, models, geometry nodes, or all combined, which is also the default state. Last but not least, there is the search field. You can use the search field and provide keywords that you want to search for. Thanks to our botanic taxonomy, we are able to search, for example, trees like by their common name, like birch, pine, or others. In the top right corner, you will find additional buttons that customize the behavior of the browser. You have the preferences button, the preview scale, the sort mode, and last but not least, the spawn options panel. In here, you can customize how the spawning of the asset behaves. You can change the collection that you want to spawn the asset in, or, for example, you can change the materialistic texture sizes. To close the Engon asset browser, you use one of the close browser buttons. Those are always highlighted in red, so they are easy to see. Note that for drawing the Engon asset browser, we override the Blender preferences, which means that if your asset browser is open, you will not be able to go back to preferences unless you close the browser. This will close the browser in all other areas. Lastly, you are able to use the E key by default to toggle the browser in arbitrary area. Press the E again and the browser will be toggled off. The key map can be changed in the Engon preferences under the key map section.